Yes, so welcome back to the channel, viewers and subscribers. From I see the thumbnail and the title, then you know where this video is heading. So please remember to like, share, drop a comment into the comment section and share your thoughts. Smash the subscribe button and also click the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever any new content is uploaded. Yes, so viewers and subscribers, remember the 66-year-old man where the gunman them did rob and throw in at the underground pit at Jones Avenue in Spanish Town, leaving him there for 4 nights and 3 days. Yeah, viewers and subscribers, his name is George Smart, and right now the man do an interview and I talk beer things and I explain everything that transpired from the first night up until he was rescued by the firefighters and the police. Yeah, viewers and subscribers, instead the gunman them all threw some big stone in the pit just to kill him, but by the grace of God him still there. The man said after he was robbed by the two gunmen, them start to force him to jump in at the wall and then shove him off. Oh my gosh. Viewers and subscribers, the Jamaican Star reported the man saying, "I was forced to step in the hole by two gunmen who had prevented me from leaving after I dropped off the woman," George said. "Just as I dropped her off and was leaving the area, I was robbed at gunpoint, dragged to a pit, and was forced to jump in," George, who was speaking to the Star after his release from the hospital. He was found on Sunday after surviving 4 nights and 3 days in the pit. He was also robbed of cash, his cell phone, and a gray Nissan AD wagon motor car he used as a taxi. George said, "They didn't expect that I would survive, but only God can kill. These men could not kill me because God had another plan," he said. According to George, he spent most of the time in the hole praying that God would send a rescue angel for him. George said, "I prayed myself to sleep all 4 nights. I didn't even feel hungry. I was just asking God not to let me die in this cave and my body not found by my relatives," he said. George said, "It was a mixture of hope and doom as he assessed his situation." So viewers and subscribers, when you hear that, Jano Star, them man are wicked, them wicked, them wicked. So here we know, viewers and subscribers, me have the interview, so me go make you watch it for yourself. But please remember to like, share, drop a comment into the comment section, share your thoughts, and smash the subscribe button to get notified whenever I upload any new content. So here we know, viewers and subscribers, check out the interview.
What began as a story of goodwill, a journey to a friend's house, detoured into a horror story. 66-year-old George Smart, who was thrown into a pit and left to die, is today counting his blessings that he survived the terrifying ordeal.
No, I never give up. I believe my faith in God keep me alive.
Smart was on his way home. After having taken a friend to her place of abode, he was intercepted by two armed men who pulled him out of his vehicle and dragged him through the bushes of Jones Avenue to a nearby manhole.
I said I should put my foot in. And putting my foot inside, they just let me go. And they let me go, I keep going down, down. When I reach the bottom of the pit, I just rolled to the corner of the pit because I didn't expect to hear a gunshot.
The men, Smart recounts, covered the manhole. However, they frequently came throughout the nights to check if he was still alive.
They started to drop stones, big stones. They started to throw oil, like gas oil or gas, and then they drop plastic on it, and they started to catch a cave on fire.
A piece of board he found in the pit was his instrument to out the fire. After many days and nights of prayers, Smart says the manhole cover was lifted one final time.
And then I heard the police say, "It is the police." Oh, be here in my head, stand up. I say, "It is the police." And so I still staying under. I say, "How do I sure it is the police?" They turn on the police radio and say, "Hear this." And me hear the police radio tripping and they talking. Then I said, "I'm still not sure." I said, "How do I really sure? And so we send in for the fireman to come and take you out. Then I believe them.
Smart lauded the police and firefighters who rescued him, saying they were all sent from God. The 66-year-old went further to extend kind words to the men who threw him into the pit.
I forgive the two of you to put me in the pit because they are young people and they do not understand. I leave all judgment to God.